Hello dear students, now we are going to discuss about tablet coating. Contents of this session: types of coating, coating materials, formulation of coating composition, methods of coating, equipment employed and defects in coating. Tablet coatings may be used simply for aesthetic reasons, to improve the appearance of a tablet, or to add a company logo, or may be employed to mask an unpleasant taste or odor, or to protect an ingredient from the decomposition during storage. So what are the different approaches behind application of coating to the tablet? So first is to improve the appearance of the tablet. Second is for unique identification, the company may add logo during coating. Third is to mask the unpleasant taste or odor of the active ingredient. And the fourth is it imparts stability to the tablet and it protects the ingredients of the tablet from decomposition during storage. Currently, the most common type of tablet coat is film. That is, film coating is more common. However, several older preparations such as vitamins and ibuprofen still have sugar coats, and some of the Ayurvedic or herbal formulations are also available in the market with sugar coating to improve its palatability. The presence of coating presents a physical barrier between the tablet core and the gastrointestinal fluids. So coated tablets therefore not only possess all the potential bioavailability problems associated with the uncoated conventional tablets, but are also subjected to the additional potential problem of being surrounded by a physical barrier. So whatever the bioavailability problems are there for uncoated tablets, along with this bioavailability problem, additional problem is provided with the coated tablet, that the barrier is there between the tablet core and the gastrointestinal fluid. So in the case of coated tablet, which is intended to disintegrate and release drug rapidly into solution in the gastrointestinal fluids, the coating must dissolve or disrupt before these processes can occur. So there is need, as the tablet coating is the potential barrier or additional barrier between the gastrointestinal fluid and the active ingredient which is present in the tablet core. So there is need that the coating must be of such type or should be ideal that it should dissolve and disrupt completely to release the drug or active ingredient in the GI tract or in gastrointestinal fluid for better bioavailability. The physicochemical nature and thickness of the coating can thus influence how quickly a drug is released from a tablet. So the composition of the coating, decides the physicochemical nature, and the thickness of the coating which is applied on the tablet, these influence the drug release from the tablet. In the process of sugar coating, the tablet core is usually sealed with a thin continuous film of a poorly water soluble polymers such as shellac or cellulose acetate phthalate. So these are sealant materials which are used to seal the tablet core, as in sugar coating, sugar syrup is going to applied on the tablet and there are chances that the core may absorb the moisture from this syrupy solution and it may impart the instability to the tablet. So the sealing coat serves to protect the tablet core and its contents from the aqueous fluids used in the subsequent steps of the sugar coating process. But the disadvantage of the shellac is that on long storage, it retards the disintegration and dissolution rate of the tablet. Tablet coating principles, now we are going to discuss. The application of coating to tablets, which is an additional step in the manufacturing process, increases the cost of the product, and therefore the decision to coat a tablet usually based on one or more of the following objectives. So application of the coating, no doubt it increases the cost of the tablet as well as it increases the weight of the tablet by 1.5 or doubles the actual weight of the tablet. And hence the decision to apply the coating is based on the following facts. That is to mask the taste, odor or color of the drug, to provide physical and chemical protection for the drug, to control the release of the drug from the tablet, to protect the drug from the gastric environment of the stomach with an acid-resistant enteric coating, to incorporate another drug or formula adjunct in the coating to avoid chemical incompatibilities or to provide sequential drug release, to improve the pharmaceutical elegance by use of special colors and contrasting printing for unique identification of the formulation. So these are the needs. That's why the tablet coating is applied, though it increases the cost or it increases the weight of the tablet. Types of tablet coating. So different types are there. Sugar coating is there, film coating, enteric coating, control release coating, and specialized coating such as compressed coating, electrostatic coating, deep coating, and vacuum fill coating. Equipment for tablet coating are standard coating pan, which is provided with the Pellegrini pan system, immersion sword system or immersion tube system, perforated pan system in which Asila Cotta system is there, high cutter system is there, glad cutter system is there, and dry coated system is there. Fluidized bed coater is also modern equipment used for the tablet coating. Let us discuss standard coating pan. It is of three types or with three different accessories: immersion tube system, glad immersion sword system, and the Pellegrini pan system. In immersion tube system, the tube immerses in the tablet bed. Tube delivers heated air. In immersion tube system, the coating solution is applied with the heated air from the immersed tube. So this has different components of the immersion tube system. Here is the tablet bed, here spray nozzle, air sac. So coating solution is sprayed along with heated air. Atomized air is there. So atomized air is supplied through this inner tube, and the outer tube supplies the spray of the coating solution. Then here is the this whole represents the pan, coating pan, which is revolving in clockwise direction, and here is the exhaust to remove the air outside, and here it is the inlet air supply. So tube supplies coating solution as well as the air, hot air. Pellegrini pan, this is provided with the baffles, and the tapered sidewall is there. So diffuser, which distributes the drying air uniformly over the tablet bed surface. Separate spray nozzle is there, which is spraying the coating solution, and these baffles help to distribute the dry air over the tablet bed surface. Then immersion sword system is there. So perforated metal sword device immerses in the tablet bed. So dry air flow flows in this direction. This is the coating pan. Feed material is there, that is tablet, and this is the immersion sword. So drying air is introduced through this device and flows upward from the sword through the tablet bed. This is the figure which represents the perforated pan system. In perforated pan system, Asila Cotta is there, high cutter system is there, glad cutter is there. So spraying gun, exhaust air, then this is the tablet bed, mixing blade, and the pan is rotating, and inlet air is supplied from this duct. So drying air is directed into the drum with the blue color arrows and passed through the tablet bed and exhausted through the perforations in drum. So these are the perforated pan system where perforations are provided, which helps to exhaust the air from the drum. The vast majority of film coated tablets are produced by a process which involves spraying of the coating material onto bed of tablets. So Asila Kota is one of the example of equipment used for film coating. High coater system. Here air supply is there. This is the inlet air supply and this is the outlet air which exhausts the air. And tablet bed is here and pan with perforated flaps. And in this way, the various spray atomizers are there. Number of spray atomizers are there which are spraying the solution throughout the bed. So this is the high coater system. Then GLAT coater. It is the latest perforated pan coater to be introduced in the industry. So in this, drying air can be directed from inside the drum through the tablet bed and exhausted out through an exhausted duct. Die coater pan. So drying air enters through hollow perforated ribs located on inside periphery of the drum. So these are various hollow perforated ribs which provides the drying air. As the coating pan rotates, the ribs dip into the tablet bed and drying air passes up through exhaust is from the back of the pan. So here is exhaust which is at the back of the pan. Fluidized bed system. In this system, fluidization of the tablet mass is achieved in a columnar chamber by the upward flow of drying air. The airflow is controlled so that more air enters the center of the column, causing the tablets to rise in the center. The movement of tablets is upward through the center of the chamber. So here, this fluidized bed operator, where the bottom spray is there, here top spray is there. Here continuous process, and when the air stream is on, so whether the spray is from the top or bottom, it is uniformly applied on the tablets. So here tablets are there and the spray is sprayed and the tablets move upward direction and the spraying solution is applied on this tablet and then tablet comes to downward. Here tablet bed is there and different spray systems are provided at a particular distance and this spraying system is applied the solution, coating solution from the top and this is the continuous process for the application of the coating on the tablet. And when the air stream is on, so in the bottom spray system, so this air stream will flow like this, the direction of the air will be like this. So this air, due to pressure, the tablet which is present here, they are moved upward and then come downward due to the gravitational force. And during the movement of the tablet from upward to downward direction, the coating solution is sprayed along with the hot air which continuously drying the coating. They then fall towards the chamber wall, move downwards to re-enter the air stream at the bottom of the chair. Coating solutions are applied from a spray nozzle which is located at the bottom of the chamber or are sprayed onto the top of the cascading tablet bed by nozzles located in the upper region of the chamber. So here it is the nozzle which is applying the red color coating solution and the tablets are continuously moving upward and downward, and when these are moved upward forcefully, the coating solution is applied. Two basic systems used to apply a finely divided spray of coating solutions or substances on the tablets are high pressure airless and low pressure air atomized spray system. So liquid is pumped at high pressure, that is 250 to 3000 pounds per square inch gauge, through a small orifice, that is 0.009 inch 0.20 inch in the fluid nozzle, which results in a finely divided spray. In this, the degree of atomization and the spray rate are controlled by fluid pressure, orifice size, fluid pressure, and the viscosity of the liquid. Liquid is pumped through a somewhat large orifice at relatively low pressure. So when the orifice size is large, that is 0.02 inch to 0.60 inch in diameter at relatively low pressure, that is 5 to 50 psig, whereas in high pressure it is 250 to 3000 psig. Low pressure air contacts with the air liquid stream at the tip of the atomizer, and finely divided spray is produced. The degree of atomization is controlled by the fluid pressure, fluid cap orifice, viscosity of liquid, air pressure, and air cap design. The type of coating, the first type of coating is sugar coating. It involves the application of sugar solution with color for several times to give uniform and elegant film. Traditionally, sugar coatings form the bulk of coated tablets, but today film coatings are the more modern technology in tablet coating. So, description of tablets: smooth, rounded, and polished to a high gloss after application of the coating, and the process is multi-stage process involving 6 separate operations. So, advantages of the sugar coating are: it prevents unpleasant odor, it gives sweet taste to tablet by masking the bitter taste, and highly elegant and gloss tablets are obtained. So the different steps of sugar coating are: sealing, that is application of water permeable polymer such as shellac, cellulose acetate phthalate, or polyvinyl acetate phthalate, which protects the core from moisture and increasing its shelf life. Subcoating is done by adding the bulking agents such as calcium carbonate or talc in combination with sucrose solution. So subcoating is done to round the edges of the tablet and to provide the bulk or to increase the weight of the tablet if it is required. Then the next is application of the syrup solution. So after subcoating, syrup solution is applied. And then the next is smoothing process, that is remove rough layers from forming step 2 with the application of the sucrose syrup. Then coloring for aesthetic purposes of titanium, often titanium based pigments are included. So coloring agents are also added along with this syrup solution. Then the next is polishing. So effectively polish to give characteristic shine or gloss to the tablet. And the commonly used polishing agents are beeswax and carnauba wax. So let us discuss one by one. Sealing, that is waterproofing. So this involves application of the coat of waterproofing substance, that is alcoholic spray, pharmaceutically shellac, and the polymer such as cap. Then approach of the sealing is that sugar coating are aqueous formulations which allow water to penetrate directly into the tablet core, and thus potentially affecting product stability and possibly causing premature tablet disintegration. So application of the many coats of partially or completely water insoluble polymer in this step enables the sugar coated product to exhibit modern modified release pattern. Subcoating, so when large quantities of sugar coatings are usually applied to the tablet core and increases the weight by 50 to 100%. So why subcoating is done? In order to round off the tablet edges, and much of the this material buildup occurs during this stage and is achieved by adding bulking agents such as calcium carbonate to the sucrose solution. Anti-adherence, that is talc, may be added after partial drying to prevent the sticking of the tablets together. Then smoothing, the subcoating stage results in tablets with rough surfaces to facilitate the color application, which requires smooth surface. Subcoated tablets are smooth by a thick sucrose syrup coating. Then color coatings usually consist of thin sucrose syrup containing the requisite coloring material, that is water soluble dyes or water insoluble pigments may be used. This step must be done into a clean pan deprived of any residues from the previous operations. Otherwise, it may result into the different color combinations or defecting coloring. polishing after the coloring step, the tablet surfaces tend to smooth but somewhat dull in appearance. So to achieve glossy finish, final stage involves application of waxes such as beeswax or Cornova wax. Then printing. So different tablets could be identified by manufacturer logo, product name, dosage strength or other appropriate code. So for sugar-coated tablets, such identification could only be achieved by printing process using special edible inks. So this is the sugar-coated process. So coated core material, and the coated material is applied. Then this is the coated particle and this is the sugar-coated particle after drying. Film coating. So modern approach to coating tablets, capsules or pellets by surrounding them with a thin layer of polymeric material. So here the polymeric materials used are polymers, which is dissolved in a solvent, suitable solvent. Plasticizer is also added to improve the characteristics of the film or to give the flexibility to the film. Then colorant is added to improve the aesthetic appearance of the tablet. The solution is spread on to a rotating tablet bed followed by drying, which facilitates the removal of the solvent, leaving behind the deposition of the film, thin film of coating material around each tablet. Advantages of the film coating process are: produce tablets in a single step process in a relatively short period of time. Process enables functional coatings to be incorporated into the dosage form. Disadvantages: there are environmental and safety implications of using organic solvent as well as their financial expense. So organic solvents are, their residues are evaporated into the environment, so these are not safe, and they are also cost-wise not reasonable, but the drying rate is rapid. Types of film coating: immediate release and modified release. So polymers which are used are cellulose derivatives, vinyl derivatives. The polymers which are used for extended release coating are ethyl cellulose, and for enteric coating are methacrylic acid copolymers or phthalate esters. Plasticizers used are, so these are used to modify the physical properties of the polymer to make it more usable, and its ability is to decrease the film brittleness. So polyethylene glycol 400, diethyl phthalate and fractionated coconut oil are used as a plasticizer. For aqueous based spray systems, water miscible plasticizer should be used. Colorants: any permitted colorants in a film coat formula are invariably chosen. So water insoluble colors or pigments have certain advantages over water soluble colors, that they tend to be more chemically stable towards light and provide better opacity and covering power and optimize the impermeability of a given film to water vapor. So examples of the colorants are titanium dioxide, aluminum flex and iron oxide pigments. Solvents used are, so modern techniques now rely on water as a polymer solvent because of the significant drawbacks that readily became apparent with the use of organic solvents. So non-enteric materials are HPMC, methyl hydroxyethyl cellulose, ethyl cellulose, HPC, polyvinyl pyrrolidone, sodium carboxymethyl cellulose, polyethylene glycols, acrylate polymers. Enteric materials are cellulose acetate phthalate, acrylate polymers, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose phthalate and the polyvinyl acetate phthalate. Difference between film coating and sugar coating. So tablet retains the shape of original core, here rounded with high degree of polish. Small weight increase is there after application of sugar coating, that is 2-3%, whereas here larger weight increase is there, that is 30-50% or sometimes 100% also. Logo or break lines possible, here also logo or break lines possible. The process can be automated using Acylacota. Here, difficult to automated, traditional coating pans are mainly used for the sugar coating. Easy training operation, considerable training operation is required. Single stage process, it is multi-stage process. Easily adaptable for control release, allows for functional coating. Not able to use for control release apart from enteric coating. So as sealant material is applied, so this can be useful for the enteric coating. Press coating, this is the modern coating. Use of compression to form coat around the preform core. Use mainly to separate chemically incompatible materials and also for dual release patterns possible. So here we can put the immediate release material, and here we can put the sustained release material, and these two types of dual pattern release patterns can be achieved. Press coating is used to separate chemically incompatible materials. So one or more being placed in the core and the other in the coating layer. However, there is still an interface contact left between the two layers. So in such cases, the process of free coating can be done one stage further. So it is possible to apply two press coatings on a tablet core using suitable equipment. So this equipment produces press coated tablets with perfect separation between active core and coating, as the two can be separated by an inert middle layer. So coating defects. So this photo shows multiple defects. So initial problem was erosion of the tablet edge due to a soft or friable tablet, or because the pan was too running, turning too fast, or both. So peeling and breakage occurs there. Here, one broken tablet can distribute particles to all other tablets and their appearance. These tablets likely broke because they had poor hardness. This photo shows very porous tablet prevented the coating from adhering to the surface. This tablet should have been coated longer and the atomization pressure should have been reduced to decrease the slight orange peel or texture surface. This is the peaking defect due to excessive moisture within the tablet, which prevent the coating from adhering on the surface of the tablet. However, the tablet coating also pulled the granulation out of the tablet, and this is usually caused by overwetting of the tablet or by a tablet that is too soft. Orange peel effect, that is the inadequate sparing of coating solution. So reasons behind orange peel effect are rapid drying or high viscosity of coating solution. So orange peel effect can be eliminated or avoided by decreasing the drying rate and decreasing the viscosity of the coating solution. Then another coating defect is bridging, that is shrinking or pulling away of film form corners. So over this may occur due to overwetting, less viscous liquids, or spreadability problems. So the solution is not spreaded properly. So change the formulation. We can change the coating composition. We should increase the viscosity and decrease the application rate. Blistering. So removal of film due to rapid evaporation of solvent from tablet core. So rapid evaporation of solvent due to increase in temperature. So we should decrease the temperature to avoid blistering, drying temperature. High viscosity of coating solution. So dilute the coating solution to decrease the viscosity to avoid blistering. There are some questions. Thank you.